Hello everyone, this is Ted with OAXRAY, and today we're going to be talking about one of our supported sites, Acme Tools. We've supported it for a little while, and today I'm getting around to making a video. Few things to note, shipping over $199 is free, or you get $6.49 shipping flat rate on all their items anyways. You also get same day shipping on most items, so you'll get the items pretty quick. I like tools, and that's kind of my favorite area to go to. So I'm going to go to category, and I'm going to go to air tools and see what we come up with. And I'll go with air hammers and chisels. And I'm going to run the OAXRAY extension by clicking it and seeing what we come up with. Now, running it here, we see... Okay, on this page we have one positive ROI item, so I'm going to pull that up. Now you might notice that you only see the column for Acme Tools for this video. I've removed the compare current store. I've clicked on the compare current store button, which removes all the kind of the other websites that we support, and it only shows you the current store. So all these ROI and net profit will be based on just the store we're looking at. If I only want to see positive ROI, I can click there and I can see the one item that has a positive ROI. And I'm going to open it up in Amazon and then click over here, see the picture, open it up in Acme, make sure they're the same item. Pistol grip, needle, sealer, or scaler. I'm just kind of getting some information so I can make sure they're identical. Needle sealer, 19 needles, 3 millimeter. Let's see if I can find that. Okay, from looking at the details, they look like the same item. It's really hard to tell because I can't see that little black piece here. Little red piece, I mean. I'm going to look for this little logo on both to make sure they're identical. Okay, just looking at these two, I'm not sure why the button is red here, but I believe they are the same. Let's look one more time. Okay, what I'm going to do is make sure there's not a duplicate listing, and this is what I would do if I were you and I was trying to make a buy decision. There could be multiple listings, and... looks like this is it. I can remove some, and maybe if I just do this, we'll get some more results. Okay, this is definitely the listing after doing some word searches. I'm just making 100% sure they're identical. I don't see any reviews on this item, but as I scroll down, yeah, looks like there's no reviews. The item is 80,000 in automotive. That's what OAXRAY told us. It's 6.6 pounds. And whenever I look at the dimensions, it's 6 inches by 6 by 6. Whenever I look at the item, that doesn't look quite right. So I'm going to make sure I plug this into the FBA revenue calculator to make sure everything is correct there. But I checked my reviews. I don't see any. If I saw a lot of negatives, then I'd be concerned about returns and negative feedback, but I'm not worried about that. What I'm going to do is do the FBA revenue calculator calculation. So I'm on the FBA revenue calculator page. I'm pasting in my ASIN and just making sure. Yeah, as I thought here, no one's ever sold this item FBA. So the size and those things were not accurate. Or at least they've never been checked into a fulfillment center, so the item has never been measured. So I'm going to look on here and get the best information that I can to try to figure out the size. It doesn't look like it's going to be oversized, so I don't think it's going to really matter too much, but I don't see any size, so I'm going to go with 12 inches long, maybe Fits in a box 6 inches wide to 6 inches down. So I'm going to do 12 inch length. This is some of the things that you may end up doing. I would guess high on these so that you don't end up with the surprise later of it actually being a little bigger than you thought it was. But it does not look like it's oversized. If I bought this, I definitely wouldn't buy a lot of them because I'd want to make sure that the box is not overly large and then causing it to be oversized. But since here, I would price it at about $410. Let's see. $410. See what we get. And our buy price, what are we buying it for? $307. Not going to be much margin here, but this is just an example. So make sure you take that into consideration. Inbound shipping on this probably is going to be about $1.50. I'm thinking that we could probably fit maybe five or six of these in a box. And let's say each one will cost a couple bucks to, couple dollars each to ship in, maybe $1.50 or so. So if we sell it for $410, inbound shipping, we're doing $1. You can do a little higher if you want, since it is 6 pounds. And in the prep service field, I put the buy cost. Now, I already checked out. You always want to check out Ray's, see if you can get some gift cards. You can also check out Gift Card Granny. Actually, let's try that. And Gift Card Granny is kind of a compiler site, which compiles a whole bunch of different gift card websites and will tell you. So yeah, they don't have any either, so I guess we can't get any there. But we do have Ebates, which gives you 1.5% off, which is 1.5% on this item is about $3 off. So we can look at that also. But on this item, it looks like we're going to spend about $300, make about $50 on the item. It's a low margin item, relative low ROI item. And yeah, that's just what it is. Low ROI item. What are we talking? $300 there. Looks like we're about 10, 15, about 15% ROI on this item. And as we go back to Amazon, we can do a final check before we were to buy anything. Let's pretend we were going to buy this. Make sure your views are good. Make sure there's not duplicate listings. Scroll down. Make sure you actually check on Amazon. Revenue calculator. Do your estimates of size, estimates of weight, and put all that information in. We do not want a surprise when we ship it because Amazon doesn't have the dimension information on hand. So when our software, OAXRAY software, calculates this, they send us some empty information. So we're essentially estimating what these weights and what these dimensions are because Amazon does not have these dimensions in their FBA center. So for this item, someone must have put these dimensions in here, 6 by 6 by 6, which probably is not correct. When I'm looking at the item, the picture, it's probably longer. So that's one of the reasons we always check the FBA calculator itself so we can make sure everything is accurate. Thank you. Have a nice day and make some money with OAXRAY.